Irritable Bowel Syndrome, or IBS, is a functional pain disorder afflicting nearly 12% of the population. It is characterized by chronic abdominal pain associated with altered bowel habits with no specific evidence of identifiable organic disease. Sufferers often experience elevated anxiety and may not respond to traditional pain medications or treatments. Recent research using brain imaging technology has begun to shed light on this troubling pain disorder, transforming our current understanding of IBS. Normal GI function depends on integration of intestinal motor, sensory, autonomic, and central nervous system activity interacting with the brain via bidirectional circuits, collectively termed the brain-gut axis. Via these pathways, the brain processes visceral information to create sensations, including emotional and cognitive perceptions, and triggers analgesic pathways capable of modulating ascending nociceptive input. Upon gut distension, spinal afferents originating in all layers of the gut wall carry sensory input to the central nervous system. Nociceptive input that evokes pain sensation travels along multiple pathways to the brain. Upon arrival at the thalamus, signals are routed to the somatosensory and cingulate cortices, as well as the insula, prefrontal cortex, and hypothalamus. In the somatosensory cortex, pain sensation is localized. Meanwhile, the cingulate, prefrontal, and insular cortices contribute to pain perception, intensity, emotional experience, and coping. The hypothalamus, an area responsible for stress responses and the initiator of the HPA axis, is also activated during pain sensation via its connections with the cingulate and prefrontal cortices. The signal cascade eventually triggers a fundamental pain control system. Descending influences from the periaqueductal gray in the midbrain to the dorsolateral pons and rostral ventral medial medulla modulate nociceptive signal transmission at the spinal level. Functional MRI of IBS sufferers shows decreased cortical activation in both the cingulate cortex and the insula during painful gut stimulation. Subsequent structural MRI shows significant cortical thinning in the cingulate cortex, insula, and prefrontal cortex of IBS patients. It is clear that in IBS, the brain-gut axis is altered. But thinned, underactivated cortex is not the only abnormality seen. Further analysis shows that the hypothalamus in IBS patients is enlarged. When considered together, these findings may help explain the experience of sustained abdominal pain and anxiety in IBS. Inadequate stimulation of upstream cortical centers may result in inadequate stimulation of the brainstem's pain control system. And hyperactivity in the hypothalamus may contribute to IBS-associated stress and anxiety. But in light of these discoveries, researchers face new questions. Is cortical thinning a result of glia, astrocytes, neurons, or even dendritic spines disappearing or shrinking? Or perhaps there is a reduced synaptic density? Is the opposite true in areas that show increased gray matter like the hypothalamus? Do abnormalities in the brain predispose individuals to chronic pain? Or are functional and structural deficits a product of chronic pain conditions? Further exploration of the brain-gut axis will illuminate these issues, potentially providing insights into developing effective pain management programs for sufferers of IBS.